The era of easy communication, easy opinion, social media. Frankly, people monitor others' opinion views. Even fashion choices are noticed very closely. And if you are, in fact, the Prime Minister of the world's largest democracy, then it's a given that every minute detail is, in fact, every minute, every small detail is monitored very closely. Now, PM Modi found this out after he posted an image of himself sporting sunglasses. And Twitter exploded with memes. Here's more on that.
This image is the subject of many memes, jokes, ridicule and discussions in India today. Prime Minister Modi wanted to witness the solar eclipse, the last of this year. He was unfortunate, he could only see glimpses due to cloud cover. But Twitterati weren't so unfortunate. They saw every minute detail, including the sunglasses. The image even set off debates. Maybach luxury sunglasses worth nearly $2,000 or 1.5 lakh rupees, or retro buffalo horn glasses worth anywhere between 3,000 and 5,000 rupees. But net-net, netizens didn't miss a meme opportunity, which even the Prime Minister acknowledged and welcomed. Some said the luxury glasses prevent the Prime Minister from seeing the economy. Others hailed him as the coolest Prime Minister ever. Hashtag Maybach even trended for a while. This is par for the course in India. Ask former Congress President Rahul Gandhi. He has had his share of such trends. Roughly 2 years ago, Rahul Gandhi referred to the Indian government as Suit Boot Ki Sarkar. This was a reference to PM Modi's extravagant suit when he met former US President Barack Obama. Modi's suit had his name in gold embroidery. But little did Rahul Gandhi know that the Suit Boot Sarkar jibe would come back to haunt him. When he wore an expensive 2-in-1 Burberry jacket in Meghalaya, the BJP hit back. The jacket was worth nearly 63,000 rupees. The fun fact is that both the Modi suit and the Gandhi jacket were gifts. This is not just an Indian phenomenon or a modern phenomenon. The fashion choices of politicians have always been a talking point, but these days leaders are more conscious. Julius Caesar was obsessed with fashion. Cleopatra's melon coiffure survived time. Louis IV made France the fashion capital of the world. Winston Churchill popularized romper suits. Nehru jackets survived long after his death. Margaret Thatcher created the image of a strong leader with an unfashionable wardrobe. Madiba shirts are still a phenomenon. King Jong-un wears the Mao suit. But not all fashion choices come off. For instance, the notorious Marie Antoinette ignited slave trade with her cotton dress. In the modern day too, sartorial choices have come a cropper. Nancy Reagan, former First Lady of the US, accepted clothes worth $1 million during her husband's 2 terms as president. Her behavior hurt the White House. Earlier this year, choice of dress became a major political potboiler in Brazil. Brazilian politician Ana Paula da Silva's outfit for her swearing-in ceremony sparked a debate. Da Silva says she has a right to dress as she chooses. Her male-dominant opponents called her names. Leaders are aware of this scrutiny more than ever. Think of Barack and Michelle Obama, Vladimir Putin, Theresa May, or Elizabeth Warren. There are even analyses on the links between dressing style and presidential chances in the United States. The Indian Prime Minister has taken to fashion like no other. From traditional Northeast attire to dhoti and shirt in South India, here is a leader who uses sartorial choices as a tool to connect with people across India. But the sunglasses episode will remind him that he is being watched every living minute. Winston Churchill once called Mahatma Gandhi the half-naked fakir. Today, Prime Minister Modi has been christened branded fakir. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.